Look, it's from the Goldstone Crows League, my friend. Remember that case? It's strange being back in Goldstone again, my friend. We should speak to the police officer in charge of this crime scene.
Hello, I'm Howard Dickens, Deputy Sheriff of Goldstone. Who might you two be? Beg your pardon, detectives. I didn't recognize you at first. Thanks for coming so quickly. As for this case, well, I've been deputy sheriff a long time, but this is the first time I've seen someone dress up a victim in a crow mask. Not only that, but just this morning we found another body, an unidentified girl. No witnesses for either murder. You're our best hope for stopping this killer. Of course. Do whatever you need to do. Look, I'm gonna be sheriff soon, so I can't have an unsolved case, you know? I know one thing. She's not local. I know everyone in Goldstone. Thankfully, we require registration cards for all visitors, so I hope I'll find her among them. Well, I should get to it. I'll find the second victim's identity while you two investigate the Crows League.
Thank you.
It seems Alan Gillinger is here. He's a member of the Crows League, and if I recall, he still owes us a favor for saving his life. I hope he keeps his promise. Come, let's hurry to his house.
Thank you.
Alan's father has died. That's why he returned to the city. However, it seems he hasn't been home for a long time. I fear Alan may be in danger. I think he'll forgive us for intruding. Let's inspect everything thoroughly.
Thank you.
so much has happened since our last visit. There's a new leader of the Crows League, and Lenore has been murdered. It seems one of their own members did it, but was it the member who lies dead in that gateway? And what does that other girl have to do with it? We need more information, my friend. No, I believe we've seen all we can here for now, until we find some ways to unlock those mysterious caches. I propose we return later. I suggest we visit the Crows League at the theater. Alan said they haven't changed that meeting spot. Maybe they can tell us something new. I also found this in a diary.
Beloved did everything we wanted. Now he's attached to us by blood. He can't escape from Goldstone. The people will bring him back soon enough.
So that's why you locked me up. You tricked Alan.
And it worked. Alan thought you were dead. Tonight, he'll belong completely to the Crows.
So, Lenore isn't dead.
Hey, glad I... Thank you.
What do you want? Who are you?
Thank you.
You made it. I can't believe you avoided all those traps. Anyway, what did you want to talk about? What? Ellis is dead? What happened? I knew my payback was coming. I just never imagined Ellis would be the one to suffer for my crime. Detectives, I'll tell you everything, in the hopes you'll prevent others from suffering like her.
What a tragic story.
Thank you.
checks.
Back already, detectives? What did Mr. Brown say? Whatever.
That man. God!
Thank you. Yeah.
Now that we know everything, I fear the best we can do is to tell the truth to Alan and Lenore. I'm sure...
Detectives, I remember you. You saved us back then, and we're still grateful. I don't know what it is, but there's a bad omen whispering in the wind. No! Alan! Detectives, justice may be defenseless against the crows, but I shall punish them. This I promise you. Where is Alan?
That boy is even stupider than I thought. You deserve a real man, my dear Lenore.
I won't ask again. Where is he?
I'm afraid Alan's tender heart couldn't handle the guilt of being a hired assassin. When I told him the truth, he killed himself.
What? No! You made him do it! Crows! With the great wings as my witness, I vow that I am no longer one of you. And I won't rest until all the ones who betrayed my mother and Alan are dead. Today, I walk the path of revenge.